Welcome back to our science class. In the previous video, we discussed heat and temperature, the differences between heat and temperature. Now in this video, we are going to know an activity which brings an important question. Come on, look at the board. The question is like this: write an activity to prove that the average kinetic energy of the molecules is directly proportional to the absolute temperature. I repeat the question: the average kinetic energy of the molecules is directly proportional to the absolute temperature. To prove this activity, we should take some material, two beakers, hot water, cold water, and some colored powder, the powder of any color. Now we have to take hot water in a bowl, cold water in other bowl, and after taking water in these two bowls, we have to take some colored powder, and with our hand we have to sprinkle the powder, the colored powder, in those two bowls which contains hot water and cold water. Come on, here when you sprinkle the food colored powder on the surface of the hot water, then you have to observe what will happen. And again you have to sprinkle some food colored powder on the surface of the cold water. Now you have to observe in these two cases what will happen after sprinkling food colored powder in these two bowls. So generally we observe that when we are heating water, the particles of the water moves randomly. So while we take this hot water, the particles in the hot water moves. When you observe the movement of the particles of the hot water with the movement of the particles of the cold water, the movement of the hot water is more than that of the cold water. And at the same time we observe that the particles of the water move randomly. So here in these two cases, the movement of the particles of the hot water is more than the movement of the particles of the cold water. The movement in a random way, or the random motion, is nothing but zigzagging. What I am going to say is, the particles of the water zigzag in the hot water and in the cold water. The zigzagging of the hot water, the zigzagging of the particles of the hot water is more than the zigzagging of the particles of the cold water. Here we have to mention an important issue. The particles of the water are moving. When a body is in movement, or the particles of a body is in motion, what will happen? Because of the motion or the movement of the particles in a body, that body gains some internal energy. That internal energy is nothing but kinetic energy. So what I am going to say here is, the motion of the particles of a body leads to the production of the kinetic energy in any body. So here in these two cases, the first case hot water and in the second case cold water, the particles of the hot water and the particles of the cold water moves in a random way, and that's why there is some internal energy produced. There is nothing but kinetic energy. So movement of particles is more in hot water. Just now I have told you that the movement of the particles leads to the production of the kinetic energy. Think, if the movement of the particles is more, that means more kinetic energy is produced internally in that body. So that is, if more kinetic energy is produced, here we have to mention the internal energy or the kinetic energy is nothing but the heat produced in that body. Because of the movement of the particles of the body, kinetic energy is produced. That kinetic energy is in the form of heat energy, that is internal energy. When the movement of the particles is more, kinetic energy will more. That means more heat is generated internally in that body. That means motion of particles causes kinetic energy. Motion of particles causes kinetic energy. That means heat produced here because of this kinetic energy. How does this kinetic energy come in that body? Because of the motion of the particles of a body, kinetic energy is produced in that body. That kinetic energy is the internal energy of the body. That's nothing but the temperature. That's nothing but heat. When heat is more, the kinetic energy is more, heat produced will be more. That means heat is increasing. As we discussed in the earlier class, the degree of hotness is nothing but temperature. The measurement of hotness or the measurement of coldness is nothing but temperature. In the previous video, we discussed that temperature is the measurement of hotness, or the degree of hotness or the degree of coldness is called temperature. So here, motion of particles causes kinetic energy. This kinetic energy produces heat in that body. So here, when you observe all the particles in these two bodies, one is hot water and the other is cold water, particles are in random motion. That means different particles have different kinetic energy. Then if we take hot water as a single unit, we have to take the average kinetic energy of that body. If we take cold water as a single unit, we have to take the average kinetic energy of that cold water. So here, different particles move randomly with different velocities, so that they have different kinetic energies. So because of different particles are having different kinetic energies, we have to take the average kinetic energy of that body. So we have to consider average kinetic energy here in these two cases. One is hot water case and the other is cold water case. So in this movement of the particles, because of the movement of the particles, kinetic energy is produced here. This kinetic energy is the internal energy, and it is nothing but heat produced. Because of the motion is more, kinetic energy will be more and the heat produced will be more. That means heat in that body is increasing. That means the temperature of body is increasing. Here, when we think of this hot body, the random motion of all the particles of this hot water is more than that of the cold water. So because of this movement of the particles, temperature is produced in that body. So that's why we can say that the average kinetic energy of hot water is more than that of the cold water. That means the average kinetic energy of hot water is more than the average kinetic energy of cold water. Then we can say the temperature is produced due to the motion, or the temperature is an indication of average kinetic energy. So when we take the average kinetic energy of that body, the average kinetic energy of that body indicates, come on, what does this kinetic energy, what does this average kinetic energy indicate? The average kinetic energy indicates the temperature of that body. So the temperature is an indication of the average kinetic energy. So here we can say that, we can conclude that the average kinetic energy of the body is directly proportional to temperature. So when we take hot water and cold water in both bowls, when you sprinkle colored powder on the surfaces of both hot water and cold water, you can observe that the random motion of the particles of the powder, how does these particles of the powder move? Because of the particles of the water movement, we can observe the powder particles movement. So from this activity we can say that, we can conclude that the average kinetic energy of a body is directly proportional to temperature. Our question is the same. Write an activity to prove that the average kinetic energy of the molecules is directly proportional to the absolute temperature. So here in this video we discussed how to prove the average kinetic energy of the molecules is directly proportional to the absolute temperature. If this question is asked in the examination, you have to mention this arrangement of the instruments and you have to write the procedure here. Okay, and this activity you can find in your textbook in page number 4, title activity 3. Okay, thank you.